On this edition of Justin Scott and Spiegel Shouldn't Be on TV, get ready to run as the guys host the .05K.
Come on, they don't know. Come on.
We get a taste of beer that's made for dogs. The guys take the stage at a music festival. Watch as the guys host a Halloween costume contest.
All that, plus we catch up with legendary comedian Margaret Cho. It's been so great getting out around town and interacting with fans again. A few weeks ago, we actually hosted a Halloween costume contest. Wait until you see what we dressed up as.
But first, we want to take you to another signature 98 Rock event, the official kickoff to the Baltimore Running Festival, the .05K.
You heard that right. Not a 5K, a .05K, a grueling 164 feet. Let's take you out to Power Plant Live for all the race action, which begins, as any good race should, with a little stretch.
What are you looking to see from some of these people during their stretch this evening?
I'm looking to see lots of skin.
Yeah.
Lots of skin, lots of sweaty skin. Lots of peeling skin.
Yuck. What? Yeah, whoa, okay.
Lots of boils.
No, we don't want to see any boils. Maybe a mole or two. If you've got psoriasis, shout out, I go through it. But we said, hey, we got James, we got Melissa, but we said, you know what we need the best of us tonight to get this crew warmed up. And that's why we turned to the Maryland Army National Guard. That's right, our nation's fighting forces. Get in here, introduce yourself to the people.
My name's Jeremy Sergeant Jeremy Stroud. Nice to meet you guys. Good evening, Baltimore!
That's right, Sergeant Sexy. Okay, this guy's in charge of the hot as hell division. He's gonna go ahead and get us all nice and stretched out. So, sir, if you would please make your way to the front of the crowd, make your way to the front of the stage, and we're gonna go ahead and mimic what the Sarge has us do. Sarge, if you would please go ahead and lead us in the pre-race stretch. Take it away.
We need good skins, guys.
What's the next move?
We're gonna stretch out our hands.
There we go. Oh, I just definitely tore my jeans.
Damn it.
Oh, damn. I just got these jeans from Target. I am so sorry. This is an HR thing. Here we go. Look at that. Look at our nation's fighting calf muscles. Look at our nation's fighting quads. That looks like a veal cutlet you dropped on a barber shop floor. You think Putin wants anything to do with those quads? Hell no! You little 5'6" nothing. You want nothing to do with those NATO quads right there. Feel that. That's good. That's 100% American brisket right there. Josh Spiegel, World Award winner, 6, soon to be 7 time. Give us a stretch. You want these people to get down on.
How about this?
Here we go. And be sure to really kick the person in front of you just as hard as you can. Let's go for a lawsuit. There we go. We call that the frontal splitter. There we go. All right. We're feeling it? Make some noise if you guys feel good. You feel loose? You feel nice?
and Spiegel. It's our Halloween party. We're at Jimmy's Famous Seafood, Baltimore's very own. That's Justin. He's, what is it, Pyramid Head?
Yeah, whatever. Yeah, I'm like Triangle Face. Who cares?
And we got Sweet Potato Josh Spiegel right here. How are you, News Genius?
Oh, I'm in the house.
Yeah.
And I am everyone's favorite judge, Judge Judy, who, if you know, I have a crush on, a very big crush on. And if you look around, we got the place packed here. Yes, it's Jimmy's Famous Seafood.
And his magic school bus.
You may be wondering why I'm wearing a sweet potato costume. The story goes back many years to when I had a very labored bowel movement. It actually felt like I was in labor and giving birth. Not to get too graphic, but I did have to remove the entire leftovers from the toilet, put them in a trash bag, and carry them into a trash can outside. Otherwise, the toilet would have been completely stuffed up. And that is how that paraphernalia that came out of my body became known as a sweet potato. There you have it.
Did a line dance break out momentarily at our Halloween costume contest?
Yeah, of course.
Did it? I mean, I wouldn't go so far as to go, of course. It was
the wobble. All those are they're technically line dance.
It seems like wobble. It seems like an easy dance to do.
Is the wobble a line dance?
Well, I mean, what do you call it?
I have no the wobble. I got no idea.
I mean, what do you call that kind of dancing where everyone gets in line and does all the same steps?
Yeah. Would you call it? What's the other one? This slide to left. Yeah. Slide to the right. Is that a line dance? Is that just a category of dance? I thought line dance annotated country, like it had to be country. Cha-cha, real smooth. Boom, boom,
I like that. I think that's forms of line dancing.
Yeah. Oh, okay, yeah, because I think line dancing, I think it's got to be country or nothing at all. But now that I think about it, they're all dancing
in a line,
therefore, it's probably line dancing.
What about... Dun 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 dun
dun dun dun dun dun dun
dun dun dun dun dun
dun dun dun dun dun dun dun dun dun dun dun dun dun
dun dun dun fellas in the house.
Where's my good-looking ladies out there? It's a dress to impress. Girls drinking for free until 10 p.m.
Coming up next.
Is it rough?
It smells just like dog food.
I don't wear underwear because it's binding.
Up next, more footage of us out in the wild. This time, we head to the Maryland State Fairgrounds for the Trifecta Food Truck and Music Festival. An awesome event featuring the area's best food trucks and incredible live music.
Yes, at this year's festival, which featured musical tribute acts, each one of us were invited to join a band on stage and perform one song.
I joined up with a 90s tribute band, Scott sung with a Grateful Dead cover band, and Spiegel hopped on stage for a version of the song Tequila while wearing a rather interesting outfit. Watch as we attempt to explain.
I'm sorry. I apologize to Trifecta. I apologize to the band.
What is happening?
My boss wanted me to sing Meredith Brooks because I guess it was like his wedding song or something. But honestly,
you're such a showman.
Thank you. I'm a man of show.
And flannels.
I'm a man of show. To my point here,
we ain't doing
Do you know the boss? Do you know what his one comment to me after
Let's
this performance was?
About.
What's that?
I'm really bummed out you didn't sing Meredith Brooks. And he meant it. He wasn't even tongue in cheek.
Right, so here we go.
Helmet.
Doc Martin and the flannels. You're on stage.
What's up, Billy?
You
what's
decided
up,
to do Helmet instead of Meredith Brooks.
Uh-huh.
And look, I'll just say it. Knocked it out of the park.
Thank you. I will admit, I didn't stay for the
Wow.
Oh, really? This is the first time?
Yeah, let's
okay,
listen.
No, wait. No, I botched a note. Mark, you're coming up. Come on, listen.
way. Just credit time
for showing the book. I got the rock star stance. But my neck hurt.
You got the rock star stance.
Oh. Yeah. Ooh, right there. Yeah, yeah, that wasn't good. Ooh, I used terse language.
Oh.
Ooh, on too slowly. Okay, right there I recovered. Do you know, I actually looked up videos of lead singers singing. Do you see how they hold the mic? Particularly Jonathan Davis from Korn.
Good.
The guy from Drowning Pool. And John Denver.
You know how I know when you mean business?
How's that?
The bandana goes on.
The bandana goes on, thank you.
The bandana goes on, this guy.
Yes, it's mostly just to hide my hairline.
Did you plan that moment when you said, come on, let's make some noise?
Was that in the moment?
That was scripted. No, that was, I talked with the band ahead of time, just in case the band wasn't making noise. Now, you'll notice there is a guitar around my neck. I'm not playing.
No.
That's a throwback to me ruining one of this band's sets years ago by drunkenly getting on stage and taking a guitar and putting it around my neck. Thank you, Doc Martin. You guys are the best. Oh, now what do we have here?
Oh yes.
Here goes Scotty.
Grateful Dead, Better Off Dead.
Nerves 1 to 10 here.
Franklin's Tower. I was pretty nervous, man. You'll hear it. It's not good.
Well, you love the Grateful Dead,
and
so.
The shirt was like handed to me right before I went on stage, and I said, I'll just throw it on. Not realizing how tremendously fat it makes me look.
I feel like you look like you're the home run leader in the clubhouse for the Orioles. I thought that was the home run chain you were wearing.
Hey, when you fellas go on stage, picture in your mind of what you look like or the scene, is that different from when you watch it now?
Great question, 100%. I thought I looked badass, and then I saw myself and I said, man, I look like a major league kid.
Oof.
Winds dwell.
It's okay, no
Franklin's Tower that hangs a bell.
It's getting better.
It can rain tonight today.
Okay, none of us are going to be on the Voice.
0 for 2.
Can I, now I noticed there's like a little mist wafting across the stage.
Was it Radu?
Was it a fog machine? For this Grateful Dead crowd?
I couldn't either confirm or deny what that smoke is.
Because I did notice after this performance, you dove off the stage and ran to a taco truck.
I did have the munchies.
You
maybe,
did.
Maybe a little contact eye going on.
I feel like
on.
You were breathing in some low rolling fog.
Here's the second verse.
Some come to laugh the past away. Some come
you ever listen
to make one more day.
No, I haven't.
Do you notice
whichever way your pleasure tends?
We both point at something only you and I can see.
No, I was pointing at a dude in the crowd. He was in the moment.
Oh, okay. I was pointing up at the moment. And I love how some of these tribute bands, they look like the bands they're giving tribute to. That dude looks like Jerry Garcia.
He does. That's Rex. Shout out Rex. Better Off Dead. Great guys, man. Great time.
Yeah, great that crowd right
look at
there.
That. Look at that guitar work. Look at that guy. Look at him.
They were the dancers crowd.
You are good.
I mean, they had happy feet. He looks like Garcia.
Woo!
They were so gracious. You didn't have to let us do this.
Thank you. That was amazing.
Yeah, they were awesome.
Bucket
honestly,
list.
Paul
Bucket
Manna, list. 24/7. Nobody puts on a better event. It was an awesome
there
day.
There we go.
All right, here we go.
Off to eat more. Apparently.
Headlining. We yeah, you ran right over a taco truck.
News monster.
Okay, pay attention to the outfit.
Yeah, this never made sense to me. I just let you guys do it.
Thank you.
In the back of my mind, just know I was like, I have no idea why he's dressed as that.
Hell yeah.
It was supposed to include the, what is it called?
It's called hand truck.
You're supposed
hand
to be hand truck.
From like, the Silence of the Lambs.
It still wouldn't have made sense. I didn't get it.
It would have made less sense.
Directly in the eyes.
I feel like it was more like we were unleashing Josh Spiegel on the crowd. Like, he's only never allowed out once a day for fresh air and song.
On a Trifecta stage, ladies and gentlemen,
that's 98 Rock's very own Kirk McEwen and his band Petticoat Junction.
What's up?
There's our producer,
today,
Joe.
There's producer, or should I say promotions, Danny is in the background. Kirk McEwen dressed to the nines.
Always.
Yeah.
Who owns a thing like that?
I don't know.
Where do you
know?
Not even who owns it? Where do you buy that?
He was born
there. Where do you buy those clothes?
When he was but a baby, they
swaddled him. What do you type in? Rockstar jacket? Like, what do you.
Okay. All right, here it comes. Here it comes. Okay, the very first tequila. Here it comes.
Tequila!
Oh!
Swing and a miss.
3 seconds.
You're going to get another chance coming up. You're going to get another chance coming up. Here it comes. Okay. This side note is my favorite song to sing at karaoke these days because the crowd's got no idea.
I didn't rehearse, by the way. That might be
one word. You didn't practice these lyrics?
No.
Hold on, here we go.
Here
Redemption.
Tequila!
Yes! There we
Nailed
go.
It.
Stuff to land.
That one.
Look how happy Kirk is. Look how happy Kirk is. Oh my gosh, he's dancing around like he's in Woodstock. He's so happy. Oh, Josh, great job. What an awesome time at Trifecta. We hope to see you at the next one.
Coming up next.
Dude,
is it rough?
It smells just like dog food.
I don't wear underwear because it's just, it's binding.
Let's check out a pair of clips which took place inside our studio. Have you ever heard of dog brew? Yes, it's a beer meant for dogs. So of course, we had to try it for ourselves.
But first, Justin overheard that Spiegel wanted a certain tool, and Justin, always looking to be in Spiegel's good graces, went ahead and bought him one. But there's a bit of an issue. Take a look.
Here you go. You asked for it. You got it.
Oh my God.
You got a whole ass axe.
Wow.
That's not an axe. Oh, it's a hatchet.
It's a hatchet. All right. And
is this a real hatchet?
Yeah. Where did you get that from?
Amazon. And this was definitely made in some Chinese sweatshop. And there you go. Feel the weight on that. There you go.
Oh!
There you go.
It's so heavy.
Yeah, you hit somebody with that. They read and talk different forever.
I know how to take off the cover. Look at that.
And there you go. Why don't you take that out?
Go ahead. Just take that. Just take the cover.
Get that on out. Just go ahead and take the axe out.
Here you go,
just get that cover off. You should be good.
Go ahead and take that cover off.
There you go.
Why do
this.
They make this so difficult?
Just go ahead and just take it off.
Pop that cover off real quick.
Oh, yeah.
There you go.
This is what happens at home when I try to open stuff. Oh, my God.
Really can't wait for you to see this hatchet.
Yeah, this is going to be good. You just got to take that cover off.
Damn
and then we'll
it.
Go
Give
ahead
it one
we'll
second.
Just, this is, these are not
I'm
buttons.
Sitting across the table. I've already figured it out.
All right, there you go.
Oh, wait. Is it this?
No. Hold on. If you take that
just
cover off.
Go ahead and take that cover off. We're going to see this hatchet.
I'm getting dizzy.
Go ahead and just take that cover off.
We are very close.
Just, I need a break. Hold on.
Just take all the time in the world. We got nothing to do here. So.
Wait, okay, I got the top off. The Velcro top is open.
Just go ahead and take that cover off.
Wait till you see how sharp this thing is.
I'm so embarrassed.
Josh said he always wanted an axe or a hatchet, so Justin went to Amazon and got him one.
And I got you one with a protective covering.
Wait, no, it can't be that way because the buttons are... Oh, I'm sweating. My back is sweating. Why don't you open it?
I don't want to. I can, but I don't want to.
Maybe you should open
no,
it.
No, don't do it either.
Oh.
It does say on here, intended for dogs only.
I mean, so was my cat's pain medicine, but that didn't stop one of my relatives from snorting it. So let's go ahead and let's crack it open and get a sniff. There we go, Jim.
All right, here we go.
Ooh, good head on it.
All right.
Well, hello there. Yeah.
I wasn't right. expecting it to be carbonated. All right.
Go ahead and get a sniff. Get a sniff.
Whoa.
Dude. Is it rough?
It smells just like dog food.
Yeah, does it?
Let me smell it. Let me smell this.
Oh.
And let me it kind of does. Ooh.
Oh, nope. Ooh. Not a chance. I'm going to throw out.
Yeah, it smells like a pig's foot.
It does. Yeah, it smells like a pig's
it does.
Foot.
It does.
Cheers. Here we go. Oh, it does actually.
I know. It's weird.
It tastes like water. Oh, God. It tastes like watered down soup. That's it.
Okay.
Let me just crack, yeah.
smell.
Crack one. Try it. Yeah.
Oh, that's. Ooh.
Oh, yeah.
It's like tangy.
Yeah, it's got a little.
Hangs out a little bit.
Why is it tangy?
It coats your mouth.
Ooh.
Ooh.
Yeah, I mean, I don't hate it.
Go give that to Phil.
Pork bone broth, corn, corn
celery. That's what I'm getting. I'm getting the celery.
Yeah, it might be the celery in there. I think
sweet
there's like
basil, peppermint, right. Turmeric, and ginger.
They say you can like pour that over dog food.
Oh, is that a bad idea?
Yeah, that's. I saw some of the suggested ways to serve it to your dog. To like,
how many we got?
They're taking
one
four
home.
Of them. Yeah, the rest are yours, brother. Dig in. Give those
you
to Maxie.
One Josh,
you want one for four? It's
thank
got pork.
You,
it's
fine.
Got pork
thank
in it.
You.
That is a Jewish dog.
Yes.
No.
I'll let you know what Max thinks.
Yeah, that
human,
dog is
no good. I'll tell you that.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't think you're going to crack that out of the barbecue anytime soon and get cheese on your burger. But,
it's all over the room.
It's already repeating.
It's all over the room.
It's already repeating.
It's
on
coming
me.
Back at you.
Coming up next.
One time I saw this woman in a minivan making hamburgers on the dashboard.
Thanks once again for staying up late with us. Remember to listen to Justin, Scott, and Spiegel each weekday morning on 98 Rock.
Now we're going to close out this episode with comedic royalty. The one and only Margaret Cho joined us in studio and brought with her an adorable four-legged friend.
What
very
kind
sick.
Of dog?
Yes.
She's a rescue dog, so she's a Chihuahua Dalmatian.
Oh.
But she's only about 5 pounds, but she's very long in body. So that's probably where the Dalmatian is.
Did we get the name? What is the name?
Lucia Caterina Lawler.
Lucia Caterina Lawler. Oh, that is the same.
Her.
Don't scare her.
Beautiful.
I'm going to actually take off her jacket.
Do it. Very friendly.
What a sweetheart.
But sometimes she'll hump my upper arm.
She is more than welcome to enjoy herself sexually with any one of us.
It's very odd because she just gets on the couch and she'll hump my like my elbow ditch or sometimes ditch. My armpit.
Yeah, you got to find the moisture wherever you can. Joe, water dish, please.
Margaret Cho's in Studio Magoobie's Joke House this weekend. Are you a car person at all?
No, I don't know anything. I used to be a motorcycle rider.
Ooh.
Oh, that's cool.
And but there one time I saw this woman in a minivan making hamburgers on the dashboard. Like she threw down four buns and then four burgers and then four slices of cheese.
Like a short order cook.
Like a dealer. Like dealing migrants.
She's a food truck.
And she had a bunch of kids in the back and I was really going fast and I'm like, you know, I'm not going to ride anymore.
The tattoos. Let's.
Oh, yes.
What's the most recent one?
Are you still getting them or where
I
are we
am
at?
Actually, I still have to have. I want to stop till I get everything finished. So the dumbest ones I have are Abraham Lincoln and George Washington on my kneecaps because it costs $6 to spread them. So that's not finished. So that, I'm like, if I don't finish it.
That is a God-tier level joke.